Hi, this is Gary with MacMOST.com. Let's take a look at Apple's new 13-inch MacBook Pro. MacMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 600 supporters. Go to MacMOST.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So last year Apple came out with a new 16-inch MacBook Pro to be their larger model. This year they already came out with a whole new MacBook Air. So with today's announcement of a new 13-inch MacBook Pro, it means the entire MacBook Pro line is now less than 6 months old. So what's in this new 13-inch model? First and foremost is the new keyboard. So the 16-inch MacBook Pro introduced a new Magic Keyboard that goes back to the old scissor mechanism and hopefully doesn't turn out to have any of the problems that the butterfly keyboard on several years worth of MacBook Pros had. The MacBook Air also adopted this new keyboard, and now the 13-inch MacBook Pro has it, meaning that the butterfly keyboard is now dead. It's not available on any of the currently sold MacBooks. In addition, the keyboard has a physical escape key next to a touch bar and Touch ID on the other end. Let's take a look at the specs here. So the 13-inch MacBook Pro primarily is two different models. There's the model that starts at $1,299. And the model that starts at $1,799. The specs here break it out into four different models, but essentially the first two and the last two are very similar. So here's the main difference between the two models. The first has a 8th generation Intel Core i5, which is basically the same as the previous generation of MacBook Pros. So no new processor in these. The higher end one, however, has new 10th generation Intel i5 or i7 processors. So a big boost there for the higher end as long as you're willing to spend $1,800 to start. Now let's continue by looking at storage and memory. So a big change here is basically the storage goes up one level for everything at the same price. So previously the MacBook Pro started at 128 gigabyte hard drives and the higher end model starts at 512. So you're basically going up a whole step, doubling the drive space for the same price. So it pretty much ends up as a huge price cut. Because if you wanted to get something decent, you'd want to get the 256 gigs anyway. So here you don't have to pay for it. And the same thing if you're going higher end. You probably want to get the 512 gig anyway. And here you get it at the base price without having to pay more for it. Now note you can go all the way up to a 4 terabyte SSD now inside. Now memory starts off at 8 gigs for the lower end model, which is the same as before. But the higher end model starts at 16 gigs, which is kind of where you want it. And also for the first time now you can go to 32 gigs on the 13-inch MacBook Pro. Before you had to get the larger model and go to that much memory. Now no surprise here, but the graphics are integrated graphics. A lot of people are saying, well, it's the same integrated graphics, but it's actually not. It's now Intel Iris Plus graphics, which is a considerable upgrade over the previous integrated graphics. It's still integrated, it still doesn't have a dedicated GPU, but it is a big performance boost. So if your goal is to use Final Cut Pro on this machine, it actually works pretty well with the Intel Iris Plus graphics. I'm sure though if you're doing 3D modeling or using some other high-end video editor, you're probably better off getting the 16-inch MacBook Pro with its own GPU. Now a lot of the other things stay the same for this model as it did for the previous model. So the lower end still has two Thunderbolt ports like the MacBook Air, while the higher end has four. The display is exactly the same, so it's the same display basically in the same case. The Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, and the camera are all the same. And the audio and battery performance are the same as well. Now on another video note, the lower end model actually only supports up to a 5K external screen, so it won't drive the new super expensive Apple display, which is 6K. But the higher end will. It's kind of interesting that you can get the MacBook Air and drive a 6K display, but not with the lower end 13-inch MacBook Pro. The size and weight are very similar to the MacBook Air. It's a little bit heavier. The MacBook Air is only 2.8 pounds. And the width and depth are the same, but of course the height of the MacBook Air changes. It goes from a thin end to a thick end, whereas the height is a pretty consistent 0.61 inches for the MacBook Pro. So let's take a look at the prices. Here you can see those same four models shown in the tech specs. And you can go as low as $1,299 for the base level 13-inch. Go up just $200 more and you double the hard drive space. The higher end one starts at $1,800. This gives you the newer processor, 16 gigs of RAM, and a half a terabyte hard drive. Pay $200 more and you get a 1 terabyte hard drive. Let's say you wanted to upgrade that. Let's go with the lower end model with the larger drive. So you're at $1,500 right there. You can pay $300 for a faster processor, still the previous generation though. You can also pay $100 more to double your memory. And you can pay $200 more to go to a 1 terabyte drive. $600 more will get you a 2 terabyte drive. With a higher end model and the larger hard drive, you're at $2,000 already. Now you can boost the processor for $200. You can go with the new 32 gigs of RAM for $400 more. And you can go all the way up to a 4 terabyte drive for $1,000. So if you really wanted all those things, you could max out at $3,600 for 4 terabytes of storage, 32 gigs of RAM, and the top level processor. So where does this 13-inch MacBook Pro fit with the 16-inch MacBook Pro on the one end and the MacBook Air on the other end? Well, clearly if you are looking for a bargain and the lightest possible MacBook, then the MacBook Air is still the best choice. If on the other hand you want something that's portable but has tons of power, then the 16-inch is the best deal. But if you really need something in the middle, you just can't go to the 16-inch size. You want it to still be kind of small and lightweight, but you need to build some power into it, then that's where the 13-inch MacBook Pro fits in. So in this case, the bargains are at either end. The high-end bargain is a 16-inch MacBook Pro. The low-end bargain is the MacBook Air. But if you're not looking for a bargain and you don't want to compromise, you want lightweight and power, then that's the 13-inch MacBook Pro. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.